Hi, this is Sharon Machlis, Director of Editorial Data and Analytics at IDG Communications. I'm here with Episode 5 of Do More with R, Save Time with RStudio Code Snippets. Code snippets is another phrase for macros or templates. They're a way to store, well, snippets of code that you're likely to want to reuse. Most software for writing code, or IDEs, have a version of these. RStudio has them too. Let me show you how they work and how you can make your own. I'll start off by importing data I used in the last episode, IT manager salaries by year. We'll take a look at the data frame. We've got two columns, year and salary. I'm going to load the ggplot2 and scales packages and then show what a default graph of that data might look like. This is what I want my graph to look like. I spent a fair amount of time tweaking that graph code. I changed bar colors, added labels, included commas on the y-axis, centered the title and subtitle. I will never remember how to do this again. I could save the graph in a file and hope I remember where the file is. Or I guess I could make a function with all these defaults, but that gets tricky if I want to do a bit more tweaking next time. Instead, I made a code snippet. I'll open a new file so you can see how this works. RStudio also has built-in snippets, so I name all of mine starting with my underscore. If I start typing that, you'll see a drop-down list with all of my snippets. As you can see, I have quite a few there. I called my bar graph snippet my underscore custom underscore bar chart. So I'll start typing that. Select it, and here's what pops up. All my code for the graph. But not only the code, there are variables in this snippet. My cursor automatically jumped to the first variable, which I called my data frame. I'll change that to the name of my data frame, which is salaries. If I hit the tab key, my cursor jumps to the next variable, which I called my xcol. I'll change that to year. I'll hit tab again, and notice what happened this time. There are two places where my ycol variable are used. When I change that to salary on the first one, the second one changes too. And I can hit tab again two more times to get to my title and subtitle variables. Now if I run this code, you see I get a graph in my customized format. Code snippets live in its special RStudio text file that you can get to with the menu commands Tools, Global Options, Code, and then Edit Snippet here. But you don't have to go through four layers of menu commands to get to the snippet file. The Use This package has a function edit underscore RStudio underscore snippets. With auto-completion, I find that easier. You can see here. I'll run that, and up pops the rsnippets file. I put my snippet at the top of the file. The ones right below it here are the ones built into RStudio. Okay, so here's the format. Each snippet starts with the word snippet at the very beginning of a line, followed by a space, and then the name of the snippet. All this snippet code below has to be indented with a tab each line. If you use spaces to indent the code or you don't indent it at all, the snippet won't work. Otherwise, you mostly write the code you want as usual. Once each code line starts with a tab, it can have additional spaces like you see here. To add a variable, you start with a dollar sign, an open curly brace, then the number of your variable, and the colon, the name of your variable, and the closing brace. You can see that in the first line of code of my snippet, I defined variables my data frame, my xcol, and my ycol. Your cursor will jump from variable to variable based on the numbers of the variables you define. Here, 1, 2, and 3. If you're using a variable more than once, you give it the same number and name in multiple places in your code. As you can see here, 3:YY appears twice. Save that RSnippet file, and you're done. And I'm done for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the More with R video page at bit.ly/morewithr. That's https://bit.ly/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. So long, and hope to see you next episode.